Exercise 5.4.3, an addition to my book Introduction to Physical Hydrology. To the right, we see the plan view of an area where we have a river with an upstream measuring station A, where the discharge of the river is measured, and a downstream measuring station B, where also the discharge of the river is measured. Indicated by arrows is the groundwater flow, contribution to the channel reach AB. Further to the right, we see the same in cross-section. We have the river to the left and the right, the water table, and curved arrows indicating groundwater flow, the groundwater flow contribution to the channel reach AB. The discharge of the river at the upstream measuring station A equals 100 cubic meter per second, and at the same time, the discharge at the downstream measuring station B equals 120 cubic meter per second. Then, in 1 hour, the storage in the river between these two stations reduces by 45,000 cubic meter. After this 1 hour, the discharge at the upstream station A is 110 cubic meter per second. Assuming a linear change of the discharge with time, determine the discharge in cubic meter per second at the downstream station B after this 1 hour. How do we go about solving this? We need to set up a water balance for the river in between A and B, and we need to do so for the time interval of 1 hour for which we have our data. The water balance reads that the average inflow at the upstream measuring station A during 1 hour equals the average outflow at the downstream measuring station B during 1 hour plus delta S delta T, the change in storage during the 1 hour in the channel reach AB. If we have an increase in storage, delta S delta T is a positive number. If we have a decrease in storage in the channel reach AB, delta S delta T is a negative number. QA at the start is 100 cubic meter per second, and we know QA after 1 hour to be 110 cubic meter per second. So the average inflow during the 1 hour equals 100 plus 110 divided by 2, which is 105 cubic meter per second. We can apply the same principle to the downstream measuring station B. QB at the start is 120 cubic meter per second, and QB after 1 hour is what we want to know. So the average outflow during the 1 hour equals 120 plus the unknown QB divided by 2, which is 60 plus half a QB. The change in storage, delta S, delta T, it's a decrease in storage, and therefore the minus sign is minus 45,000 cubic meter. Importantly, all variables in the water balance equation need to carry the same unit of measurement, cubic meter per second. 45,000 cubic meter is a decrease during 1 hour in the channel reach AB. So we have to divide minus 45,000 cubic meter by 3,600 seconds, and this gives us minus 12.5 cubic meter per second change in storage. So now things have become easy because we know all the values. 105 is the average inflow, 60 plus half a QB is the average outflow, and the change in storage delta S delta T is minus 12.5. So we have one equation with one unknown, which we can easily solve. Half a QB is 57.5 cubic meter per second, and the QB after 1 hour, which we want to know, is 115 cubic meter per second. This exercise is a nice example of some surface water hydraulics and what we can do by applying the principle of a water balance equation. Importantly, we have to set up the water balance for a fixed area, which for this exercise is the channel reach AB. We have to set it up for a fixed time interval, for this exercise 1 hour. All variables in the equation must carry the same unit of measurement, cubic meter per second in this exercise. And if there is an increase of storage, then you have to assign delta S delta T a positive number. And if there is a decrease in storage, you have to assign delta S delta T a negative number. This exercise is also a nice example of the way you would work with a simulation model, for instance, a rainfall runoff model.